Little Roger was 10 and a half. The show was CBS's Winky Dink and You, hosted by Jack Barry. And once you sent away and got your Winky Dink kit, included some special plastic to cover the TV set. Always remember to put that on, kids. They always forgot, and parents went nuts. And you got 4 special crayons and a cloth to wipe the screen clean. Anyway, you could play Winky Dink by drawing, for example, missing features on the faces of Little Winky's family album.
You know, I have a confession to make. I've never seen Winky Dink. I was too old.
And it looked like fun?
Yeah. All Did you have a kit when you were a kid?
Yeah, Jack's going to tell me what to do right now.
Fine. And let's draw eyebrows on Aunt Martha. Just above her eyes. Any sort of eyebrows you think she should have. Use your imagination. You know what eyebrows look like. A straight line over each eye. That's fine. Very good.
I think
good.
I made Aunt Martha just look
so
like
it doesn't
banker.
Cover the eye.
That's fine, Gene. Those are probably the worst eyebrows I have ever seen.
Well, check out a mirror sometime. Now, Winky Dink and You and a lot of other old shows are available on videotape for gifts. If you want to know how to order them, we'll tell you later in the show. I think this is going to be a cult gift item. I would love to get this as a gift.
And you know, another thing, this is probably the cheapest gift because this piece of acetate cost about 15 cents.
Add a quarter for this grease pencil. Yeah. I'm telling you, the cheapest gifts are sometimes the best.
Yeah, throw away the toy, play with the box. But you know, the basic idea of Winky Dink and of the Etch-a-Sketch boards has been developed into a Christmas gift this Christmas called VideoArt. And what this is an electronic coloring book that allows kids to draw pictures in color on the television screen. For example, here I push it, it's on.
Yeah, VideoArt, right
there. There we go, right there. I choose another color, such as yellow, push in on the joystick, and look at that, Gene, look at that.
Mm-hmm.
Great art there.
Yeah, that's beautiful, you drew a line.
Yes, I did, that's...
This is like the old Etch-a-Sketch.
Yeah, you think that...
And you thought my eyebrows were bad. What else can this thing do?
Well, I've got something that I want you to do, Gene. I'm gonna push in this activity cartridge.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to start it up again,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to see a little girl there, and
yeah.
You were so good at drawing the eyebrows on
yeah.
Aunt Martha. I want to see how well... Now, you're supposed to color her in.
All right, let me see if I can color the hat.
Start with her hat. Okay. Here we go. Push in on the top of the
joystick. Okay, I'm getting
a little...
Whoa!
Wonderful.
I just
wonderful. Wonderful. Look at this. Cubism. Amazing.
I'm getting some hat, and I'm getting some ears.
That's right. And can you imagine how long it would take you to get the nose and the eyes and the teddy bear? This is a very hard toy or program. I tried to use it yesterday, and even if you get good at it, the results look crummy. The joystick is a crude instrument to draw with. It's not just that Mr. Siskel is an inept artist, and there was no way that any kid is ever going to draw a picture that looks even half as good as the one on the box. I think that this would be a very frustrating toy to get a Christmas
time. I would say I'm rather frustrated. Look at what I've drawn.
A psychiatrist would have a lot of fun with that.
Here's the real one. Look at this. They got a dog jumping out of the set. This suggests that you can do 3D.
You think kids would really take
you
that literally?
You can't even do 2D.
Would kids take that literally?
I think so. I would.
Uh-huh. Well, then in that case, we don't recommend video art.
You bet. Oh. Well, later on, we're going to go in search of the best possible video picture that you can get on your TV. And coming up next, we're going to move from our toy store here into our video shop and look at gift tapes for older viewers, like ourselves, for example.
My father made him an offer he couldn't refuse.
Continuing our tour of the Siskel and Ebert Holiday Gift Guide Shopping Mall here, we've come over to visit our friendly local video store, and we have some ideas about some new and fairly offbeat videotapes and discs that might look good under the Christmas tree. Now, I want to start with 3 music videos, 3 very different kinds of music. First, a new series called Swing, Best of the Big Band, that has assembled rare old short subject footage of some of the great bands of the 30s and 40s. Bands like Tommy Dorsey, Benny Goodman, Harry James, and in this clip, Count Basie and his sextet backing up the legendary Billie Holiday.
But God bless the child that's got his own. That's got his own.
As Glenn Miller used to say, something old and something new. This is new. Bon Jovi, one of the hottest bands in the world right now, from the new full-length video named Slippery When Wet. The movie's good. The camera angles are cliched, though. And my personal pick from all the recent concert videos now in the stores, Paul Simon in concert with South African musicians in Graceland, this year's biggest winner at the Grammy Awards. If you'd be my bodyguard, I can be your own lifestyle. I can call you.
know, I must have heard Paul Simon's Graceland album about 50 times already. Wow. And yet to see it on video with him in concert made it all fresh again. Those songs don't get old.
I enjoyed seeing Billie Holiday. I don't recall ever seeing her on film. And the way they shoot the Duke Ellington section of concert footage, just great. I think some of the best videos on the market this season, ones that I would seriously consider giving as gifts, are some of the how-to tapes. Here are three that I can recommend. First, and this really surprised me, is Christy Brinkley's CoverGirl Video Guide to Basic Makeup. This one is good. You learn, for example, how important it is to put on a foundation base, a step we're often told that women skip.
What does foundation do? A lot. It evens out skin tone and gives your face a flawless, smooth finish. Besides that, it helps protect your skin and helps your other makeup wear longer.
Even better is Wolfgang Puck's Spago Cooking from the Red Hot California Chef, assisted by various celebrities. Here, he shows Christina Farrar how to make a pasta dish.
When you make the pasta dough, it's very good if you put it together after and then you let it rest, because, you know, it's very hard to work any dough which is just made fresh.
And quite impressive, in my opinion, is my last recommendation. Larry Hagman's Stop Smoking for Life tape, in which TV's J.R. Ewing turns nice guy and gives some sensible advice about the very tough job of quitting smoking.
Some people actually feel lonely without their cigarettes. Well, after all, they got pleasure and companionship from them. So if that happens, you're not going crazy. You're just missing something you depended on. Now think of what you're gaining and call up a real friend.
I genuinely enjoyed these tapes. I don't know what better gift you could give a smoker, and the cooking tape drove home the lesson of not preparing your menu until you see what's fresh in your local stores. Get the fresh stuff. Yeah. Don't say you're going to serve chicken when chicken isn't in season.
Oh, I'll never make that mistake, Gene.
Okay.
I never will. You know, I've never been a fashion model, and I've never smoked, but right. I must say the cooking tape really did interest me for some reason. Now,
weren't you surprised at Christie Brinkley, how good she was on camera?
I was. As a matter of fact, she was very pleasant, and she told little anecdotes about, you know, getting frozen when she
was
shooting
up
in Alaska and so forth. And, that was pleasant. But I still not going to reach out to the makeup department in my local department store. And
but
I
you might
advise
give
you
it
not to either, because tongues will wag.
Give it as a gift.
Okay. Thank you. Now, out of all the thousands of feature films on tape and disc in the stores this Christmas, we want to pick just two each that we think would make good gifts, which probably means that we'd like to get them. Hint, hint. My first choice, just recently released on video, is Woody Allen's Radio Days, a nostalgic memory of the 1940s, and of a kid growing up in New York and creating an entire fantasy life by listening to the radio.
It's the Master Avenger.
It's off to jail for you. I hope you'll enjoy making license plates.
The Master Avenger is inspired by the Lone Ranger, of course, but in other scenes, Woody Allen allows himself to be mercilessly satirical of the corny old-time sports announcers.
He had one leg and one arm, but more than that, he had heart. The next winter, going after duck, his gun misfired. He was blind, but he had instinct as to where to throw the baseball. Instinct and heart.
You do not have to remember the golden age of radio to enjoy Radio Days. All you have to remember is the way your childhood heroes were kind of surrounded by magic in your imagination, and when you found out the Lone Ranger wasn't real, or when Gene found out that Winky Dink wasn't real, that was not the best part of growing up. But it was an important part, and Radio Days is a very funny film.
But I did find out that Jack Barry was real because he hosted another one of my favorite old shows that I'd love to get on tape, 21, that quiz show.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if it was fixed. It was fun. There's been a lot of price cutting on tapes going on this season, and the one that I'd buy right now is The Godfather, down from $59.95 to $29.95. Sound like a used car salesman here.
But no ups, no extras.
But this is quite simply one of the greatest mixtures of pure entertainment and extraordinary filmmaking ever made. I love the scene early on in the film when Al Pacino, home on leave for a family wedding, explains to Diane Keaton how he's different from the thugs that hang around his family.
Luca Brasi held a gun to his head, and my father assured him that either his brains or his signature would be on the contract. That's my family, Katie. Not me.
But of course, the great irony there is he is a Corleone, as the story will show. If you don't own The Godfather, now is the time to buy one of the greatest films ever made.
I agree. The Godfather is one of the great American movies.
and an even greater movie at $29.95 than it was at $59.95. My next home video choice is A Sleeper, a wonderful, hilarious movie that came out 4 years ago and is still one of the best films I've ever seen about Christmas. It's called A Christmas Story, and it's based on the memories of humorist Gene Shepard growing up in northern Indiana at a time when every red-blooded kid in America wanted his own genuine Daisy Red Ryder BB gun. Well, here's what happened to one of those kids.
No, no, I want to look at the red cover, and I said, you want to get ready by the leg rifle.
You'll shoot your eye out, kid. Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho.
And then, of course, there's that scene, you remember, where the snowfall comes and the little brother hasn't had time to get a new jacket yet, so they stuff him and put on about three sweaters and stuff him into his jacket, and he's so tightly dressed he can't move, so he falls over in the snow, and he's just stuck there. I thought that was one of the funniest scenes I've ever seen in a movie.
It is a wonderful, wonderful film, made by Bob Clark, who made Porky's. Now, how he could make A Christmas Story, such a wonderful movie, and Porky's, too, I don't get it.
And neither does his agent, because Porky's made $100 million and this one didn't.
Okay, a new release just out is Steve Martin's Roxanne, one of the year's best films. I bet he gets an Oscar nomination for the film. If he doesn't, he's robbed. For his part in this update of the Cyrano de Bergerac story, the bright man unlucky in love because of his big nose. Here, Martin handles some hecklers in a bar by making his own jokes about his big beak.
Start with obvious. Excuse me, is that your nose, or did a bus park on your face? Meteorological. Everybody take cover. She's going to blow.
A great scene. A wonderful performance by one of our finest comic talents. If you don't buy Roxanne, at least rent it.
Or if you don't rent it, at least borrow it. Borrow all of our choices.
You bet.
Coming up next, the latest electronic gimmicks and gizmos to turn your living room into a video command center. And later in the show, we try to make our own home movies, and we review each other's.
We're now in the electronics store of our video gift guide mall, where there is the latest in electronics, so-called hardware, such as video recorders and various electronic attachments or add-ons. And one of the most intriguing pieces of hardware that I have found now available is a VCR, a video cassette recorder, with a built-in barcoding mechanism. Barcoding is a device at supermarkets that electronically reads those little lines on products and tells the cash register the price, you hope. In this case, you use a separate wand, I've got one here, to touch a card that has pre-printed codes for all the days of the months, hours and minutes, and all the possible channels. And then you transmit that information to the VCR itself. I will now demonstrate. For example, I will turn it on. And here's my favorite program. It's on Saturday. And it starts at 10:30. And it ends at 11 o'clock. It signals me when I've made my connection, and it's on channel 2.
In Chicago, why, that would be our show.
You got it, big boy.
Very clever.
And now I turn it around. I point this at the VCR. And up comes, see there, look. Saturday,
amazing.
10:30 start. 11 p.m. finish, Channel 2, our show. Every week it reminds me to watch it.
This is fabulous, because you're so clever with electronic gadgets that if they had a VCR with one button, you would want the button to have a tiny voice that said, push me.
As I was just going to say, this is a lot easier to operate than most VCRs on the market today. It's designed to help mechanical clods like me who have never, ever been able to pre-record on their VCR. Panasonic has a list price of about $525 on this item, which is about $65 more than for a comparable machine without barcoding. So the barcoding thing is 65 clams. The next step in this technology is to incorporate all of these items, these dates and channels, into one single barcode. And here we have something kind of special. A Japanese magazine like TV Guide, see that little logo? And they have barcodes in a few cases for special shows. All you'd have to do is just go wipe it like this across, and you would instantaneously barcode. Right here we got a little Paul Newman movie. And maybe this will come to America someday.
The only problem is TV Guide would be the size of a phone book. Now let's get down to the bottom line, the video picture itself. Right now the home video market is dominated by the common VHS video format, but there are two kinds of home video systems in the stores this Christmas season that produce much better pictures and much better sound than anything you may have seen in home video before. They are Super VHS.
we have a brand new Super VHS machine right here. Super VHS still uses special cassette tapes. And here's a Super VHS demonstration tape. Of course, it's only going to look as good as your set will allow. Gene, you and I saw a demonstration of this. What did you think?
Roger, I was amazed at the quality. There wasn't a lot of bleeding. It was lifelike. I would want this. This, if I could afford it, I think it's about $1,200 list
price.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I would buy it. This is really high quality.
I was impressed, too. It's a terrific picture.
Yeah.
There were details like the bark on a tree,
yeah,
the details in a flower I'd never seen on a video picture before. It's great. But there are a couple of problems with Super VHS. One of them is you've got to have a monitor or TV set capable of receiving a Super VHS picture. That can cost you money if your old TV set won't do it. The other problem, there are no movies now available in Super VHS format. But there will be, and in the meantime, a Super VHS machine will play your old, ordinary VHS movie. So if you're buying a new VCR, get Super VHS, then your machine won't be obsolete.
Okay.
But there's another choice in the stores right now, and this one is all set up and ready to go. It's LaserVision. Now, LaserVision doesn't play from cassettes. It plays from discs, and it's based on the same technology as the ordinary little compact disc that people have, so that the sound is a whole lot better on LaserVision than on any tape I've heard, including Super VHS. You put it in like this. You push it in the other way. Of course, I can't make anything
work. No, just push it this way.
You don't push it physically. Gene, you're supposed to push the button, and then you push it like this, and it plays. The advantages of LaserVision are picture that's almost as good as Super VHS, sound that's better or at least equivalent, and thousands of movies and concerts and operas already available on disc. So it's a lot cheaper, too.
When I listened to this LaserVision, the thing that impressed me was the sound. The sound is spectacular,
mm-hmm.
So I recommend
so
it.
So there are two alternatives to ordinary VHS.
Both are
of
great.
Them superior. Later on, we'll review classic videos now on sale from TV's golden age. But coming up next, the moment we've been dreading, Gene and I are going to show you the first films that we've ever directed.
Okay, well, why don't you point it at me? Here, get it up.
Oh,
here.
I am pointing it at you,
way,
Roger.
Up this way.
Oh, just don't try and direct it. You see, that's the amazing thing.
Now we're back in the toy department of the Siskel and Ebert Mall, and Gene is shooting me right now on the PXL. There he is. Yes, back this way, Gene. Thank you very much. It's my shot now. Yes, that's the PXL 2000 camcorder, also known as Pixel Vision. Little camera that Gene is holding, and then this monitor here, which is also included, and the entire package sells for $225. They hope it's going to be a big item at Christmas time for kids. It's certainly a fairly expensive item. What's interesting is this little camera operates on batteries, and it records not on videotape, which is expensive, but on this cheap audio cassette tape. And there's Gene the cameraman moving in for a big close-up. There you are. Of course, the only problem is all it records on audio tape, it looks like it records on masking tape. It's not a real good picture, but nevertheless, Gene and I have taken advantage of this situation because for the last 20 years, we've been reviewing other people's movies, and so this weekend, we took home a Pixel Vision camera so that we could make our own movies, and we're going to premiere them right now. Neither one of us has seen the other's movies, and you're really looking forward to reviewing mine, aren't you, Gene? Yes, he is, yes. And then I'm going to get an opportunity to review his. So now the world premiere of my first movie in Pixel Vision.
Goodbye, Nagabite Rosebud. Get in touch with everybody that ever knew him. Oh, who knew him well?
Hello, Mr. Wilson. She won't talk. The second Mrs. Kane about Rosebud or anything else.
If you could have found out that Rosebud meant, I bet that would have explained everything.
No, I don't think so. No. Mr. Kane was the man who got everything he wanted and then lost it. Maybe Rosebud was something he couldn't get or something he lost.
Thank you.
You want to know my reaction?
Yeah, I do want to know your reaction.
I think you played too long on Citizen Kane because I was wondering when you were going to switch to the yuppie part. You waited too long. And then on the yuppie part, that's the license plate of your car with Rosebud. I happen to know that because I know it's your car. I would have pulled back farther so I could have seen that it was a BMW car. That's the way I would have
approved your absolutely no, because first of all, you have to see that it's Rosebud.
I know that you had to be tight.
You have to see the word Rosebud, and then you have to pan up to show the insignia because
that's
the punchline.
And then I wanted you to be back, go back and show that it was a car.
Well, but I couldn't because it was parked at the curb and there was another car behind me.
Yeah,
I couldn't get back.
But my other criticism is you were too long on Rosebud. The idea is cute.
Too long?
Too long on the original
Citizen Kane?
Too long.
Not at all.
No.
Not at all. No.
The movie
was supposed to be 45 seconds long. I brought it in at 52 seconds.
Yeah.
The way it goes. If the punchline any longer, it would have stepped on the rest of the joke.
You know, that's why I'm glad we don't have directors on our show, because I'm not interested in your response.
Well, I'm certainly looking forward to seeing your film.
And here is my masterpiece, and it is titled A Confessional Documentary.
And I'm Roger Ebert of the Chicago Sun-Times. Ladies and gentlemen of the audience, there's something I've not been telling you over the years, and that is the debt of gratitude I owe to my colleague, Gene Siskel. For many years, in between our weekly tapings of the show, Gene has been coaching me on what to say, every single word that I say. A lesser man would make me look stupid every week. On occasion, Gene gives me something intelligent to say. Gene, my friend, before this taping is over, in case anything should happen to me, I want you and the audience to know that I owe you a tremendous debt of gratitude. I can never repay. However, I will start paying in increments of $1,000 a week beginning tomorrow. Thank you.
Well, you're laughing. You must have liked it.
Very clever, Gene. Very clever. And you know, the thing I like the best is your decision not to put your face on camera, because that way it was fun to look at as well as to listen to.
Yeah.
Actually, the joke went on a bit too long.
The lesson I learned...
And everything that you said was so obvious.
Except that you were laughing the whole time.
Mine showed so much more imagination.
No, you were laughing the whole time. Here's the key.
I was laughing.
You know what?
I laughed more than you do.
Okay, but here's the key.
Because I'm a happier person.
Here's the key.
Okay.
The key, I think, on this whole system is if you're going to make this thing, and we'll get into the recommendation of the system in a second, but the key is simplicity. That's what I found. That one shot with the one gimmick, this is a very crude system. So if you're going to make these things, don't try and overproduce
them. Because every time you have an edit, you have to push stop. If you just push the little button on the handle, it doesn't work.
I mean, that one unbroken shot is a funny bit.
Yeah, but mine.
And all I did was just move it back slightly to get
that. So what do you think? $225 for the kids?
I would not buy it. I would not buy it only because, I mean, that's a lot of money. You can get a used camera, which these kids are so adept at operating, for not that much more money.
Yeah, but of course, the tapes are a lot more expensive.
Yeah.
It's clever, though. It is clever.
Hey, listen, if you got a lot of money, go for it.
It's fairly simple, and I think that any kid bright enough to want a camera like this would very quickly outgrow it, and he'd want the real thing. So I think you're probably right.
Okay.
Let's move on to another one of the hot items that they're going to be selling in the Christmas store, in the stores this Christmas. This is the Nintendo Entertainment System, and this is about $189, not much cheaper. Toys, remember when toys were a dollar or two?
Yes.
Amazing.
We got them, too.
A Slinky, you know, or a gyroscope or something. We're going to now play this. It has a game in it called Duck Hunt. This is the console here. You plug in the Duck Hunt, you push this button, and here we go, Gene.
Okay, three shots to hit two ducks coming up.
Three shots to hit two ducks. There's my dog. He's looking for the ducks.
Here they come.
Okay, here
get
they
ready.
Come. I got one.
No, you didn't get any.
I didn't.
You didn't get any. Zero.
Okay, wait a minute. Oh, there he is. He's laughing.
Here come two more ducks.
Here we go.
You did not get any?
I got one.
Okay. Now, we do not endorse killing ducks, even visual ducks.
No, we don't. No. Okay, you got one.
I got two.
Okay.
Thank you.
Two ducks. Big deal. Okay. Okay,
got them all.
Okay, now I want to ask you something.
Yeah.
Right now on the show, because we rehearsed this just a second ago.
Yeah.
You've never missed a duck yet.
Yeah.
Now, you told me there was a secret to the game.
There is a secret to the
game.
I figured it out.
I haven't been able
to. All right, I went to military school. I know how to shoot, and here's what you do. You aim a little bit below where you think you should aim. Aim a little bit below and look through the crosshairs. These are crosshairs.
Yeah, uh-huh.
So then you can never miss. Okay?
So what do you think?
I'm
going to
make a great soldier, but I, you know...
For $189, what do you think?
Well, I don't know how many games you get with this thing.
Well, you get two games, comes in the box, you can buy some other games and plug them in.
I'll only tell you this. The shooting of the duck hunt was fun to do. Mm-hmm. This is probably one of the games that we enjoyed playing the most.
One of the funny things is these video games are back in the market again. It was about 6 or 7 years ago that video games were hot. Mm-hmm. Then they kind of dropped out of sight, and now it's kind of like Snow White. You can bring it back every 7 years. There's a new market for it. This is basically what that is.
Okay.
Now we have another toy that we want to review, the Sega Master System. And this is a major competitor of the Nintendo Entertainment System. Both of them work in basically the same way. You get a console like this that you plug into the television set. You get little game cartridges that you stick in. And then in this case, you can also get 3D glasses. Gene, you tried this out.
Yeah, 3D games are the biggest thing that they're selling this year. And of the 3D video games on the market, the best that I could find, and the best that I played with, was the one played with the Sega Master System. It's expensive. The system starts at $100. Then, if you want to play 3D, you got to get the glasses. The glasses are $50. And then the game cartridge itself is $40, so it gets expensive. But if you don't want to play 3D, then it's 100 plus 40 for, or 30 for all the games. I'm going to play 3D and show you as best I can, because you really can't see the 3D. But you watch me play this game. Here are the glasses. These are heavy-duty glasses.
Okay,
you
don't Jim McMahon.
You do not get these in movie theaters. Okay, let's start the game, and let's play. Okay, here they go.
Saving humanity.
Oh, there you can see I'm blasting a little bit.
Yeah, now at home, this doesn't look like 3D. But believe it, I guess, the between jeans through jeans glasses, it looks
yeah,
like
yeah, it does. I'm actually getting a kick out of it. And it's tougher than Duck Hunt. And this is a real 3D effect. Okay, now I'm just punching out.
Okay.
And I'll tell you, this is not bad. I mean, if you want to play 3D, again, I think the whole thing is, this stuff is very heavily priced. If you can afford it, what we're telling you is the best to buy. And I'm saying, of the 3D, Sega Master
I'll tell
system.
You one problem I've always had. Now, I think a lot of kids wear glasses
right.
just like I did. Hold
yeah.
those.
Okay.
These are the glasses that you usually get with 3D games. Now, what do you do with them? You put them on over your ears and then stick your glasses on top of them or what? You can never. It's just like 3D movies. I can't see anything.
Right.
These glasses do fit on over my other glasses, and I was able to play the game.
Right.
Okay.
Now, there is a cheaper 3D set on the market that you can play on the Nintendo system, but as Roger said, the paper glasses just don't work very well.
Coming up next, one of the hottest categories in the video market right now, KidVid. New videos for kids. Kids you might have or kids you might know.
He's a tramp, but I love him. Yes, even I have got it pretty bad.
And now we're back in the video department of the Siskel and Ebert Holiday Gift Guide Mall. And Roger, there may be a blue light special. Hang around. You could pick up a bargain, big boy. And now we come to one of the hottest selling segments of the video market. If you have a child in your life, yours or someone close to you, you'll want to take down some of the names of some of the best video available for kids. Let's start with music videos for children under the age of 4. And one of the best sellers is called Baby Songs. And one of the best songs on the tape is called Piggy Toes.
Jiggle your piggy toes, wiggle your piggy toes. Giggle and jiggle your toes. Jiggle your piggy toes, wiggle your piggy toes. Run those sweet piggies right up to your rosy nose. Run them right up to your nose.
Another winner is a series of Disney sing-along songs taken from classic and not-so-classic Disney movies. I really got a kick out of Casey Jr. from the movie Dumbo.
Casey Jr. coming down the track, coming down the track with a smoky sack. Here's him bumping, coming round the hill. Casey, here's a thrill every jack and jill.
And finally, if you want to get your child ready for bed, the Disney lullabies work beautifully. Here's the great song, I'm Wishing, from the beginning of Snow White.
I'm wishing, for the one I love to find me.
You get about 10 songs on each of these tapes. Another favorite of mine on this, one of the other tapes is called Baby Mine from Dumbo. It's certain to cause some hugging and nuzzling in the home. These tapes are wonderful, Roger. This is a development, you know, obviously, I think one thing we should point out, we're talking about video. I'm not suggesting that video replace reading, and books should be a very important part of a kid's life, but these videos are a wonderful development. I wish I had them when I was growing up.
You know, I do too. You might have grown up to be a little more serene. My first KidVid choice for the season is also a movie that adults can enjoy, even relatively hard-boiled adults like me. It's The Lady and the Tramp, the story of a dog from the wrong side of the tracks who may only be a mongrel, but he's always there when you need him.
Another one of my choices, the fabulous Fleischer Folio, classic animated cartoons by Disney's greatest competitor, Max Fleischer.
You're boring this labour.
Bauman's Chinese Theater on Hollywood Boulevard is famous for the footprints of celebrities that are embedded in its concrete sidewalk.
And my third choice is from the Random House Looking Glass Video Library, a series of children's classic stories illustrated by favorite artists and read by famous stars. Here in The Elephant's Child, Jack Nicholson reads Rudyard Kipling's story of how the elephant got its nose.
And the elephant's child's nose kept on stretching, and the elephant's child spread all his little four legs and pulled and pulled and pulled.
And I really like that approach. There's a whole series of these here read by people like Jeremy Irons, Cher, and Meryl Streep, who did two or three of them. And it's like being read to out of a picture book. The drawings are good.
Yes, they are.
And
very
the voices
good.
Are good.
Well, particularly that Jack Nicholson voice. I mean, you can hear him smiling, and you can almost just visualize him having fun recording into the microphone. I really enjoyed that very, very much. That's a gift that I would buy. And there are, unfortunately, some heavily promoted videos for children that I cannot recommend. And when it comes to a gift guide, I think a warning can be as valuable as a recommendation. I was truly bored by the cheesy video and story quality of the Teddy Ruxpin tape I watched. He's a little bear and also a crushing little boar. Here's a sample from Teddy Ruxpin in Escape from the Treacherous Mountains.
We really found the treasure of Kondo.
You found it, Teddy.
Well, it belongs to all of us.
And now the absurd Barbie and the Rockers, Barbie's first video. And Mattel really blew it with this one. Barbie doesn't look like Barbie. Ken doesn't look like Ken. And the idea of Barbie delivering a world peace rock concert from outer space is absolutely ridiculous. Okay, let's go to some videotapes for older kids. And here is a clever concept, nicely executed, is the video equivalent of a magazine profile you might see in Tiger Beat or 16 Magazine. In this case, 30 minutes up close with Mackenzie Astin, one of the young stars of the hit TV show Facts of Life. I like the way he's questioned on a variety of subjects, from his relationship with his father, actor John Astin, his stepfather, and his mother, actress Patty Duke. We also see him talk about stardom.
I'd be walking with my mom or having breakfast with my dad, and I'd say, Dad, you're about to get recognized. And about 5 seconds later, aren't you John Astin? Or, Mom, this person knows who you are. Well, aren't you Patty Duke? Stuff like that. It's funny, and now that I'm a familiar face, I can tell when people recognize me.
He's a pretty aware kid. I can see how this type of video profile could have great potential with a variety of personalities far beyond the world of entertainment. I hope this isn't just restricted to entertainers. I think we got enough about entertainers. I'd like to hear some interviews with scientists. I happen to have a tape on an artist that I enjoyed playing and seeing him at work. Let's get these wonderful people we have on this planet before they die and interview them.
And doctors and nurses and school teachers and firemen. It'd be great for kids to see how a lot of people live their lives.
You bet.
My next selection is called The Little League's Official How to Play Baseball Video. And it's intended to instruct kids. Well, my first reaction to this, and here it's got the little thing here so you can stretch something and build your muscles up before while the snow's still on the ground. My first reaction was to dismiss this video and suggest that if kids want to learn how to play Little League Baseball, they should go out and play Little League Baseball. But then as I watched this video, I started thinking about how I loved to read how-to sports books when I was a kid, mainly because they fed my fantasies about how I was hitting the home runs instead of the kid in the book. You know, young Babe Ruth, that's me. Young Lou Gehrig, hey, that's me too. Here's the scene where
young
they
explain... Young Wayne Twilliger, that's more
thank
like you.
Very you. Much. Here's the scene where they explain how to get on base.
As your hands reach the plate, throw them at the ball. The bat will swing into the ball in front of the plate. Your bottom hand is facing down, your top hand facing up as you make contact. Follow through by swinging into, not at the ball, and bring the bat all the way around with your bottom hand.
And I'm still trying to figure out, this is called the quick fit ultra toner.
Okay.
I mean, I didn't have, that's why I was no good in Little League. I didn't have my ultra toner. Still, it's a clever tape.
You've made it through 44 years or 45 years without your ultra toner.
take a pass on it. But the tape is actually kind of good. I learned about bunting, a little bit about sliding. They don't teach you how to hook slide, but a straight ahead slide. You know what they teach you? They teach you to slide on grass.
You know
first.
What I always wanted to know in Little League was how to use the glove in order to keep the ball from hitting me in the head.
Very valuable.
When we come back, some ideas for nostalgic gifts from the vintage years of television.
Hello, folks, and welcome to You Bet Your Life.
And we're still back in the video store with an unusual idea for a Christmas gift. These are video and movie collectors magazines, like Video Shopper, Movie Collectors World.
Big Reel, Classic Images, they're great.
And these are magazines published by and for video and movie collectors, fans of old TV shows and movies who buy, sell, and trade their tapes and films from the golden age of television in Hollywood. What's amazing is that almost everything you've ever seen on TV is probably available on tape somewhere. For example, this is a catalog from Shokas Video. And look at this. I found this the other day. The Ed Sullivan Show. Guests for February the 5th, 1956. Lucille Ball, Desi Arnaz, Orson Welles reading from King Lear, and an interview with Rodgers and Hammerstein. Plus, probably that guy that spun the plates on top of the poles. Looking through the catalog, here's a show that I found from Shokas. A rare, unedited pilot tape of Groucho Marx filming his radio show to see how it might look on television.
Well, Groucho, the secret word is still name, I think. And we have some people out here who have
you
been...
Have,
so,
huh?
Yes, we do.
That's very interesting.
Thank you. Thank you. Selected by our studio audience.
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute, John.
Yeah, I know. We'll start over.
All right. Okay. All right, let's have a clean break now. Huh?
All right. I'll walk around the block.
All right. Okay, wait a minute. Will you walk on?
Oh.
Just keep walking back and forth. Until Fenneman extricates himself from this dilemma.
We change minds.
You may fire and run.
All right. You have to ask me.
Okay. What do you want me to say?
Go ahead, George.
Go ahead, George. That's some ad lib, eh?
And I don't know where they get these tapes, because that was never even played on television. Yeah. That was just for somebody's vault, and I guess somebody got the combination.
I am very glad that they saved that. Now, one of my favorite shows when I was growing up was the $64,000 question. I watched it every week, and I was delighted to discover that I could buy an episode. Here, Revlon presents host Hal March questioning a pregnant woman in the famous isolation booth about her knowledge of Sherlock Holmes.
For $32,000, I will give you seven names. You give me the title of the story and give another name by which this character was ever known. Here are the names. First, Waldron. Next, Signora Victor Durando. Third, Henry Peters. Then, Jack McMurdo. Next, James Winter. Sixth, Vandeleur, the schoolmaster. And finally, James Armitage. You have 30 seconds to think over your answer. Good luck, Bobby.
What a show. That booth, that music, that's almost like music from Psycho now. You know, we used to think of ding, ding, ding. It's heavy-duty music. It's much more threatening than I remember it. Now, I couldn't care if some of the contestants were briefed beforehand. It is great theater. And if you want to know how to order the $64,000 question or the Ed Sullivan Show that Roger was talking...
Or Winky Dink.
Or Winky Dink, like we mentioned before, it's from Shokas Video. We're going to give them a big plug because they've given us a lot of pleasure. Shokas Video, order from them... Post Office Box 8434, Van Nuys, California, 91409. The cost of the Shokas tapes is $20 to $25, and you just don't get one half-hour show. You get about 1.5 to 2 hours of programming.
I think I'm going to send in for Jack Benny. He was always my favorite. Coming up next, our choices of the worst video gifts in the market this holiday season. A couple of real rip-offs. Now comes the fun part. It's time for our selection of the worst video gifts available in this country this season. Now, Gene and I have both watched dozens of tapes. We have played with lots of video games. We have tinkered with innumerable gadgets. And we have found the bottom of the video gift barrel. Gene, what did you find down there?
Well, my pick is a kiddie ripoff called Lady Lovely Locks. It's one of those customized things available for kids. It used to be in books where you could insert your name. Now you send in your picture and they insert it into a video. But my picture popped up only a measly 4 times in the 25 minutes of this tape. And the voice to suit all kids is absurd as I try to offer help to Lady Lovely Locks, who's looking for her friend.
I wish I could remember where Maiden Fairhair and Curly Crown said to me.
I know where they are, Lady Lovely Locks. My goodness. Hi, Jean. Hi, Lady Lovely Locks. I saw them in a meadow as I floated by in my balloon.
Why, thank you. I'm meeting them there for a picnic. Would you like to join us?
Thank you, lady, but I have to get home for dinner.
That's great. I'm too busy to enter the adventure. I've got to go home. That's why I got the tape, so I could go home, right? I couldn't interact with Lady Lovelocks. Of course, they do it that way, so they don't have to insert my picture throughout the story. That is a ripoff. Do not get Lady Lovelocks.
I won't, Gene. I won't. And I also won't get my choice of the worst gift of the year, which is right here. It's called Zap It. Now, how does this work?
Well, bug operator.
Here it is, you see.
Kills
you
bugs.
Take off this little tape backing here, and then you tape it to the back mm-hmm. of any remote control zapper on your TV set. It'll work with anyone. And then, you know what?
What?
You no longer have to point the zapper at the set to make it work.
You can point
it. No, sir. You can point it anywhere. I can point it up. I can point it down. I can point it behind me. And no matter where I point, the zapper works. Now, in my opinion, the only people who would need this gadget would be people too lazy to simply pick up their arm and point their zapper at the TV set, and people that lazy would certainly be too lazy to go out and buy Zap It. So I think for $25,
yeah.
This is utterly worthless. Just, I mean, remote control used to be considered a sign of decadence. This is decadence on top of decadence.
I know. For $25, you know what they always say. One good tape is worth 1,000 Zap Its. And that's our survey of the best and worst video for the holiday gift buying season. Our regular movie balcony is closed, but remember, your local shopping mall is open.
Redken Classics hair care products formulated to create beautiful, healthy hair. So effective, their formulas transcend time. Available exclusively at salons. Backed by popular demand, your favorite old-time chewing gum, Beeman's Blackjack and Clove. A different taste experience. Beeman's Blackjack and Clove for a limited time only. Tap and SureCook Space Saver Microwave is perfect for kitchens where space is at a premium. Tap and Touch Solid State Controls, Automatic Temperature Probe, and Wood Grain Decor, furnished by Tappan. It's a great Christmas gift for VCR owners, the bigger than ever 1988 edition of Roger Ebert's movie Home Companion.
Thank you.